1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the OHRH Harvest Radio Hour, brought to you by Carroll County Fresh. Today's broadcast is on April 7th, 2012. This is Show 6 of Season 3. I'm your host, Dan Croats. We're broadcasting to you from high atop the Grandview Hotel, looking down on the little town that time didn't forget, but has treated nicely anyways, Berryville, Arkansas. Dr. Sharon Sloan, our technical director, is in the control booth, and she is frowning at me, and it appears that she is cussing in a non-ladylike way. Sharon, you shouldn't do that. Whoops. The look she just gave me was worth about $5, I guess. Anyways, it's hard to believe that we've been around for 3 whole years. Today's program has a bit of something for everyone. Track 1, for those of you listening to our podcast version, is the first half of an interview with Victoria Marshall and Peggy Duncan of the Good Shepherd Humane Society. If you care about dogs and cats and the humane treatment of animals in general, you will be interested. We'll finish up our interview with Peggy and Victoria on track 2 and then visit with Jill Stice, who is the director of the Little Sprouts Children's Garden over at the First Christian Church in Berryville. Jill will tell us how she's helping children develop some enthusiasm for gardening and helping them understand all about sustainable agriculture. Later in the program, we'll share some information about the 2012 Carroll County Fresh Photo Contest and some farmers market news. Now, let's hear from Peggy and Victoria at the Good Shepherd Humane Society. We're at the Good Shepherd Humane Society in Eureka Springs, across from the Queen Anne Mansion on Van Buren, right on Highway 62 West. Our guests today are Victoria Marshall, a volunteer at the Humane Society, and Peggy Duncan, a board member. Welcome to the OHRH Harvest Radio Hour.
Thank you. Thank you.
I appreciate your having us. Peggy Duncan, can you tell us about what the Good Shepherd Humane Society does, what its mission is, and all of that kind of stuff?
Yes. We are a basically no-kill shelter. We try to be, unless it's more humane that they be put down, you know, for injuries or illness, whatever.
Okay. Now, when you talk about you being a humane society shelter and a no-kill shelter, you're talking about dogs and cats?
Basically, yes.
Okay, mm-hmm. So mostly mm-hmm. dogs and cats.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. Yes. I'm sorry for interrupting
That's
you.
Okay. That's All okay. Right. We were founded in 1974 by Oscar and Amy, or Otto and Amy Mayer. There was originally 23 members. Mm-hmm. They had were located out on 23 South. The first thrift shop was actually opened in 75
wow.
by the mayors, and they immediately saw they needed more funds as the reason they did this. And they then in 1977, they were given a memorial fund from a lady that passed away of mm-hmm. $25,000.
Okay.
And they enabled them then to build a shelter, and their first shelter out there, and actually were able to hire their first manager, and her name was Judy McClellan, and they were able to house more animals then, but immediately ended up being overwhelmed then even, and had to house animals outside even then.
Uh-huh.
In cages outside because of the need.
The shelter is located sort of halfway between Eureka Springs and Berryville, right?
Yes, it is now. It's out on 62 East, just outside the city limits.
All right. And,
on the left as you go out.
And about how many dogs and cats do you have out there?
Right now we have about 30 dogs, I believe, and 30 cats.
All right.
We have the capacity for 122 of each.
Wow.
We are really low right now. We're begging.
Uh-huh.
We could adopt out a lot more than that if we had them.
Uh-huh.
Right now we're low. We've been adopting them just right and left. I mean, people have been coming in right and left.
Well, I know that there are lots and lots of pictures of adoptable pets on social media.
Mm-hmm.
On Facebook and, mm-hmm. and so on. So I see those quite often. But how do animals get into the shelter?
They're brought in several different ways. They are brought in by people who surrender animals.
Uh-huh.
They are brought in by Eureka Springs, Berryville, and Green Forest. Dog catchers,
uh-huh.
who bring them in, they pick up, and then they're brought in by people that tell us about them, you know, that when they're on the like side of the highway or whatever,
uh-huh.
and they're brought in that way. Mostly they're surrenders that are brought in by people.
Okay.
And those people pay us to take the animal.
Is that right?
Yes. That's one of the ways we make money.
So if I were to bring my old Jack Russell Terrier in, not that I ever would, but
mm-hmm.
if I were to do that, how much would it cost me to surrender her?
I'm not sure of the exact price.
Uh-huh.
I think it's a moderate fee, but not real high. But
uh-huh.
I'm not sure of the exact price of that.
Okay.
We have just recently changed our rates to be more moderate, but I'm not sure of the exact price.
All right. Well, when an animal comes into the Humane Society shelter, what happens to the animal?
It is gone over by one of the vets there. We have two different vets that give their time to us on a monetary basis, and they go over the animal to make sure it's in good health. It is put in quarantine for a few days if necessary, if it has anything wrong with it, you know, that could be of danger to the other animals, and then it is put out to be adoptable.
I see. All right. And what kind of animals come in? I mean, what sort of breeds of dogs and breeds of cats?
We get all breeds, from little bitty Shih Tzus and Chihuahuas and Yorkies on up to St. Bernards and all. Most of them are mixed breeds. We get very few purebreds, but
mm-hmm.
once in a while we do get a purebred brought in.
Uh-huh.
But most of the animals are mixed breeds.
Well, I want to give you a personal endorsement. My wife and I got a little Jack Russell Terrier from the Good Shepherd Humane Society 9 years ago. It's hard to believe that we've had Sophie, the Jack Russell terrorist, with us that long. But we've been really, really delighted with our dog and always grateful to the Good Shepherd Humane Society for letting us bring Sophie into our family. So, Victoria, you describe yourself as a volunteer here. What does it mean to be a volunteer at the Good Shepherd Humane Society?
Well, right now my job is to sort and price items that come into the Eureka store.
Uh-huh.
And we get bags full of things and we go through them and, like I said, you know, decide what the prices are going to be and put them out.
Okay. And you volunteer because A, you love going through junk, or B, you like animals?
B? Yeah.
Okay.
Sometimes going through junk isn't real fun.
Yeah, and I didn't mean to describe your stuff as junk. You have a lovely store here. But tell us about your motivation to be a volunteer here.
Well, I saw the I saw an ad about a year ago in the lovely County Citizen that they needed volunteers, and as I was aging, one of my things on the bucket list, if you will, is to do more service and volunteer work. So.
Ah, all right, great. And you decided to choose Good Shepherd because?
Animals.
Animals.
Yep.
All right. Are you a pet owner? Have you been?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Yes. We got Bonniekins, the Beagle Basset mix, in December of last year from Good Shepherd.
Ah, all right.
Yep. Yeah. I had to replace my Beagle who died last year.
Ah, okay.
So I found a mix.
Is that, maybe both of you could answer this question, is that typical of volunteers who come to Good Shepherd?
Just
is it a love of animals?
Yes, and we have a hard time turning them down when we see them. My only good fortune is that I live where I can only have one, or I would have a house full. Because when I go out there and see them and they're looking at me with those little eyes, I have to turn my back.
Uh-huh. All right. Very good. Peggy, maybe you can tell us about how Good Shepherd is structured and organized. You have a board, for example.
Yes. We are a 501c3 nonprofit, and we have a board of directors who is answerable to a membership.
Uh huh.
And we do everything strictly by the rule.
Okay. How does one become a member of the Humane Society?
We have a membership form. It's $20 a year for an individual, $40 a year for a family, or $100 a year for a corporate.
Ah,
right. $100 a year also for a lifetime.
Okay. So if I wanted to become a member of the Humane Society, I would contact who?
Right out there at the desk.
Okay.
A member. Anybody. You can come to the thrift stores, you can go to the Humane Society itself. All of them have forms.
Okay.
They turn those forms in to me. I issue a card to you, and you are a member.
And then you get to run for the board and vote for board members. Is that right?
Exactly right.
We're talking with Peggy Duncan and Victoria Marshall at the Good Shepherd Humane Society in Eureka Springs. We'll be right back after this brief message.